Everyone, welcome to Indian Online School. Hope you all are doing well and preparing well for your Olympiad exams. So students, as you all know that Olympiad exam dates are approaching, this is the high time for us to get perfect in this examination. So for this purpose, we are going to discuss about a sample paper so that you get an idea of how to do this paper. Okay, so in this class, I'm going to explain you grade 2 sample paper for doing this Olympiad examination. So students, this paper consists of 35 questions, and the time allotted for this paper is 60 minutes, that is 1 hour. Okay, so basically your paper will be like, it consists of different sections, like around 4 sections you will be getting in this paper. Like the first section is about word and structure knowledge, okay. So, and the second section is about reading. You'll be given a passage and you'll be asked questions from the given passage. And the third section is about spoken and written expression. In this, you'll be given a conversation kind of questions, and you have to fill in that particular blank using a appropriate conversation. And the last section is about achiever section. This is a little tough when compared to the other sections. And for this section, you'll be getting 2 marks for each question. So in total, as I have told you, you'll be getting 35 questions, right? And the marks allotted for this test is 60 marks. And for the first 30 questions, you'll be getting 1 mark for each question. And for the achiever section, as I told you that this is a quite tougher one compared to the other section, you'll be getting around 2 marks for each question. Okay, students? So you have to be very careful while answering the achiever section, okay? So let us go to each section, okay, in deep. Okay, so we'll start with the first section first. So the first section is about word and structure knowledge, okay? So in this section, you'll be asked questions from the grammar part, the whole of the grammar, okay? Like parts of speech, spells, antonyms, synonyms, okay, correctly spelled word, and sometimes you'll be given the images and you have to recognize the image of the particular picture, okay, the name of the particular picture. And then you'll be given the second section, that is about a passage, okay? You have to read the passage carefully and you have to answer the questions accordingly, okay? And that is the easiest part of this paper because everything is being mentioned in the passage, and the only thing is you have to read the passage carefully and you have to write the correct answer, okay? And then spoken and written expression. As I've told you, you'll be given a conversation. 2 people or sometimes 3 people will be talking. They will be talking, and you have to fill that particular blank with the appropriate conversation, the appropriate word, okay? And in achiever section, you'll be getting questions from grammar, sometimes antonym, sometimes synonym, or correctly spelled word you have to find out, okay? This is all about the achiever section, okay? So let us practice one of the sample paper, okay? So students, this is our sample paper of Olympiad, okay? So this is the first section of your Olympiad paper. So the first section says, for question 1 and 2, choose the word which is spelled correctly. Okay, first you have to find out the correctly spelled word. First you have to find out the word that is making a sense. Okay, and then you have to check that particular word, whether it is spelled correctly or not. Okay, for example, you are given a, Yes, so this is the first section, okay? So the first question says that for questions 1 and 2, choose the word which is spelled correctly. Okay, so first what you have to do, you have to find out the particular word that makes a sense, and then you have to check the spelling of that particular word. So the first question is like, the first option is A-C-E-K, ASEC. Do we have any word by such name? No, we don't have that word. So this is absurd, okay? Then coming to the second word, it is cake. Do we have such word? Yes, we do have a cake, right? We do celebrate our birthdays, anniversaries using this cake. And then check the spelling of this cake. C-A-K-E, cake. Is it correct or not? Yes, right. So this is the correctly spelled word. And then coming to the third option, K-A-C-E, case. Do we have any such word? No, right? So this is again an absurd option. Then C-A-E, key, E-K. So do we have any other any word as such? No, again, it makes no sense. So the correct answer is cake. Okay, this is how you have to do the question number one and question number two. You have to find out the particular word that makes a sense, and then you have to go for its spelling. Okay, so the first option is concert. Do we have any such word? Yes, concert is nothing but a musical performance. A musical show is called a concert. And then check its spelling. C-O-N-C-E-R-T. Yes, this is a correctly spelled word. Concert, a musical show is called a concert. So this can be our answer. But go to the other options also. Then sense court. Do we have any such word? No, this is not the right answer. This can't be our answer. Okay, so leave that thing. Then coming to the option number C. Torsen. Do we have any such word? No, we don't have that word. So leave that. And then coming to the option number D. Necot. Do we have any such word? No, it's again a wrong option. So the correct answer is concert, option number A. So this is our right answer. Okay. Then go to the question number two. Again, you have to find out the correctly spelled word. Lambish. Do we have any such word? No, we don't have this word. So leave this option. And then go to the second option. Shimble. No, again, we don't have any such word called shimble. Okay. Then go to the option C. Blemish. Yes, we have a word called blemish. What do you mean by that? It's nothing but a mark that spoils the look of anything. Okay. So it is a correct word. And let us check its spelling. Blemish. Yes, B-L-E-M-I-S-H. So this is the correctly spelled word. And then coming to the option D, this is our right answer. And then option D, mesh bills. No, we don't have any such word. So leave this option. The correct answer is option C, blemish. Okay. Then for question number three, choose the synonym of brave. What do you mean by brave? Who is not afraid of doing anything. He's fearless. It's called brave. Okay. Then go to the option, cowardly. What do you mean by cowardly? The person who does something in a very fearful way, he is afraid of doing anything. That person is said to be a coward person. And doing that such action is called cowardly. So it can't be the meaning of brave. Brave is something that is done without any fear. So cowardly can't be the synonym of the given word brave. So synonym is basically nothing but similar meaning of the given word. So it can't be the right option. So leave that thing. Then coming to shy. Shy is again something which you do with a kind of fear, hesitation. Okay. So it can't be again a synonym of brave. So leave this option. And then calm. It is silent. Being calm is being silent, being quiet. Okay. And again, this is not the synonym of brave. So leave this option. Then coming to the fourth option, it is adventurous. What do you mean by adventurous? Someone who is very interested to do something. Something unusual. He's not feared of doing anything. He's not afraid of doing any kind of challenging thing. That person is said to be an adventurous. Adventurous. Okay. So, yes. Brave is, the synonym of brave is adventurous. Okay. Now, we have the fourth question. Choose the antonym of bored. Antonym means opposite. Okay. Opposite of bored. What is bored? The thing which is not interesting is called bored. Okay. Then cheated. Can it be a antonym of bored? No. Cheating. Okay. Cheated is nothing but something related to cheating. Right. So it can't be the antonym of bored. So leave that option. And then silly. What do you mean by silly? Foolish. A foolish person is said to be a silly person. And no, it is not related to bored. Okay. Then excited. Excited means? When you are interested to do something, that is called excited. Okay. So, yes, it can be the antonym of bored. Bored, uninterested, not interesting. Excited, interesting. So, this can be the antonym of the given word bored. Now, let us move to the fourth option. That is sporty. Sporty means someone who is very good at a particular sport. Okay. So, this is nothing related to bored. Okay. So, leave this option also. The correct answer is excited. Got it? Okay, students. Now, let's move to the next one. So, for the questions 5 to 8, what you have to do? You have to choose the correct answer. For example, which animal does not have legs? Okay, so you have to find out the particular animal which does not have legs. So let's see the first option, horse. So can you see legs to horse? Yes, right. It has four legs. So this can't be our answer. Then fish. Can you see legs to fish? No, right. So this can be our answer. Then let's move to the third option, cat. Yes, cat also has four legs. Dog, yes, dog also has four legs. So the correct answer is fish. Okay, so the same way you have to do the other questions also. So the question five is about which thing do you use to eat? Yes, so floor. Do we use this to eat? No, we sit on the floor, right? So this can't be our answer. Saucepan. Do we use this to eat? No, it's used to cook, right? So it can't be our answer. Spoon. Yes, we do use spoon to eat our food, right? So this can be our answer. Now let's move to the option number four. It is pencil. Do we use pencil to eat? No, right? It is used to write. So the correct answer for us is option C, spoon. Okay, now let's move to question number six. Which one of this is healthy food? Ice cream. Yeah, it's yummy, but is it a healthy food? No, you may get throat pain once you eat this thing. Okay, so it's not a healthy food. Pizza. Yes, it's yummy, but no, it's not a healthy food. It's a junk food. Okay, it has negative effects and sometimes you may fall ill. Okay, it's not a healthy food. Candy. No, even it can't give you any health, like it's not a healthy food. Okay, so this can be your answer. Pear. Yes, it's a fruit. Fruits and vegetables are good and they are good and nutritious food. So this is a healthy food. A fruit is a healthy fruit. So option D is a correct answer. Okay, now question number seven. Where can you not sing songs? Yes, so school. Yeah, obviously we don't sing songs, but sometimes like when we have some kind of celebration, annual function, we do have like songs at all in the school. So no, this is not the right answer. Okay, library. Library is meant for what? For reading. And we are not supposed to make noise in library. And definitely we are not supposed to sing songs in library. Okay, so this can be our answer. Next, lounge. What is a lounge? It's a room. It's a kind of hall in hotels where people do keep waiting for somebody. Okay, so it can't. We can sing song here. Okay, so it's not the right answer for us. Now, bedroom. Yes, we can sing song in our bedroom. Right, so the correct answer for us is library. Okay, now question number eight, which is not made with metal? Yes, hard substance. So car, yes, car is definitely made of metal. So this is not our answer. Pin, yes, it is again made of metal. So this is also not the right answer. Napkin, it is made of cloth. It is not made of metal, right? So this can be our answer. Next, chair, yes, we can have wooden chair, metallic chair. So this is again not a correct option for us. So the correct answer is napkin, okay? Now, for questions 9 to 15, choose the correct option to fill the blanks. Okay, so you have to choose the correct option and you have to fill your blank. Okay, for example, Sarah is riding Dash bike. Okay, so Sarah is riding Dash bike. So here the bike can be Sarah's. Okay, so basically what we have to use here, the pronoun that shows the possession. Whose bike? Her bike? Whose bike? Okay, so yes. She, is it a possessive pronoun? No, it's a personal pronoun, right? So we can't use she in the given blank. Okay, then coming to her, is it a possessive pronoun? Yes, it can be a possessive pronoun which can show the possession of Sarah. Sarah is riding her new bike. So this can be our answer, right? Now hers. Hers is also a possessive pronoun that is used to show your possession. But if we use this possessive pronoun here, it is not giving the proper sense. So it's grammatically incorrect. Sarah is riding her bike. No, we can't use it in the middle. Basically, this possessive pronoun is used at the end. Like, this handbag is hers. This new bike is hers. Okay. But when we use this possessive pronoun in the middle of the sentence, then we can't use this one. Okay. So leave this option. Then, him. Again, we can't use him. Okay. Like, Sarah is a girl, so this is basically used for a man, right? So we can't use this pronoun here. So the correct answer here is her. Sarah is riding her new bike, okay? Likewise, you have to answer the questions from 9 to 15 using the appropriate option, okay? I can't find Dash favorite shoes. I'm sorry. Okay, so when you are sorry, so you can't say, I can't find we favorite shoes. You can say, I can't find our favorite shoes, right? So we can't use this one because we have to show the possession again. Okay, I can't find I favorite shoes. No, again, it is not showing the possession. So it can't be the correct option. I can't find you favorite shoes. Again, you is a personal pronoun. It is not showing your possession. It is not a possessive pronoun. Okay, so this is not our answer. Next, I can't find your favorite shoes. Yes, your is used to show the possession. Sorry, possession. So this can be our answer. I can't find your favorite shoes. I'm sorry. Okay, this is how you have to find out the correct option. Next, he always enjoys dash program that was just on TV. Okay, so we are talking about a program that was just shown on TV. So now we have to find out the appropriate, the correct article. So when we are referring to something general, so what are the articles that we use? Indefinite articles, a or an, right? When we are referring to something in particular, then we use the definite article, the, right? So now here, what are we referring to? We are referring to a program. We are not mentioning the particular program, okay? So here the correct article that we have to use here is a. Because program P is a consonant, it's starting with a consonant, okay? So we have to use a here. We can't use the, we can't use no article, no. We do require an article here. So and cannot be the correct article because P is a consonant and we have to use the definite, indefinite article a here, okay? Next, I would like to have either this style of hat dash that one. Again, when you have options, right? When you have options, then what is the conjunction that you have to use? It is or, right? This style of hat or that one. So when you have options, it is very obvious that you will be using the conjunction or here, right? Already either is given here, so we can't use this option. And when do we use and? When you have to join the two similar ideas, like I like chocolate and ice cream. Okay, so we can't use that. And so when we use so, when you have to give the, when the second event is happening before the second first event, then we have to use this conjunction so. So the correct answer for us is or here because we have an option. We have to choose between the two things. Okay, so we have to use or here. Okay, next. Look at dash beautiful puppies that have come over here. Now it is about puppies. Okay, look at dash beautiful puppies. It means plural, right? So basically we can't use this and that because they are meant for singular things, right? So now we have to choose between those and these. And when do we use those and when do we use these? These two are used when we are referring, like this is for plural and this is also for plural, right? And those is used to refer to something which are far from us, right? And these to refer to something that are close to us, near to us. And when we are saying that come over here, it means something close to us, right? Look at these puppies that have come over here, okay? When these puppies are close to us, we have to use these here. Clear, everyone? Okay, now coming to the next question. It's important that we get home dash 9 p.m. at the latest. So it's about by this time you have to reach home, not after that. Okay, when we have that time limitation, what is the preposition that we have to use? It is clearly by, right? We can't say out. We can't use in. We can't use with. It's important that we get home by 9 p.m. So by is our correct answer. Okay. Next, my father never eats dash because he likes to savor his food. What do you mean by savor? He wants to enjoy the taste of the food. So he never eats. We can't use this fasten. We can't use this fastest. We can't use it as fasts. Okay. My father never eats fast. How he never eats? He never eats fast. Okay. So the correct option here is fast. Okay. Fastest is used when we have more than two people, okay? And when we have to make the comparison here, only one person is there, my father, and we have to describe his action, okay? So fast is the correct adverb, okay? Next, I have never dashed a pineapple before. So here have has come. So what I have told you, when you have, it means it is related to present perfect tense. And always remember, with present perfect tense, you have to use the main verb in V3 form. Okay. So eat. What are the three forms of eat? Eat, ate, and eaten. So our V3 form is eaten. Okay. So the correct answer here is eaten. I have never eaten a pineapple before. Okay. Now, coming to the second question. Okay, now here you are given a picture and you have to answer the questions that are being asked. Okay, so you have to look at the picture carefully and you have to answer the questions. Okay, so now the first question is, like, for example, there are dash footballs on the ground. So you can count from here. Okay, how many footballs are there? Count all the number of footballs here. So in total, how many we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so 10. Okay, this is how you have to answer the questions based on the picture. Okay, now there are five children dash. So you can count on, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And this is coach. We can't count a coach in students or children, right? So how many students we have? We have five children. Okay, not students, children. And what they are doing? They are sitting on a bench, right? They are not shouting. They are not sleeping. They are not eating. They are sitting on the bench. Okay. Now, coming to the next questions. They are sitting on what? We have seen it, right? They are sitting on a bench. Okay. So, the right answer here is bench. Okay, this one. Next, the coach is dash then the girls. How is the coach? Happiest? No, we can't see it, right? We can't see the face of those people, the children and coach. So, we can't decide whether they are happy or what. Okay. And bigger, yeah, obviously the coach is bigger, right? You can see here, the coach is bigger, okay? And smaller, no, the coach can't be smaller. You can see from the picture, right? So this is not the right answer. And active, we can't decide that, okay? So the correct answer is bigger. Footballer number 4 has dash bottles on the bench on her right. So number 4, football number 4, yes. How many bottles she has? 1, 2, okay? So you have to take option containing the answer 2. Okay, so this is the right answer. Now the coach on the far left has no dash. So what she has? She has sorry, what is the option given? Shoes, hair, number, shorts. Obviously, what is written on her shirt? It is coach, right? It has no number. So the correct answer here is option C, number. Okay, now going to the next section, that is passage. Okay, read the passage and answer the questions that follow. You have to read this passage carefully. Okay, so yes, we'll go through this. Canada is one of the most popular tourist destination in the world. There are many attractions for Canada visitors, and kids love to explore the amazing nature and wildlife. Families also can go on great canoe trips in the national parks or enjoy skiing and snowboarding and other winter fun activities in the mountains. But also the big cities such as Toronto, Quebec, and Vancouver have lots to offer to families traveling with kids. Canada has two official languages, English and French. Almost half of the population can speak both languages. Most Canadians speak English as first language, but French is the main language in the Quebec province. Okay. One exciting city is called Vancouver. The Winter Olympics took place in and around Vancouver in 2010. In the city, some attractions for children are the Maritime and the Science Museums, as well as the fantastic Grouse Mountain Sky Ride or doing the cliff walk and crossing the Capilano River over the suspension bridge. There's a lot to do and see. Okay, this is about passage. Now, let us go to the question. The passage is about what? Is it about Canada, flying, sports, or a river? It's about Canada because it is most popular tourist destination. So basically, the passage is all about Canada, okay? Now, coming to the next question. What is so special about Canada? Yes, what is the special thing about Canada? We have many fun activities, the outdoors, right? It's not about food. Nothing is mentioned regarding the food in the passage. So leave that. And nothing about the people and families. They go there to enjoy. But what? The outdoors, the fun activities that they have over there. Okay. So the correct option is option B. Next, where are the winter fun activities? Where do they take place? In the city, Vancouver. Okay, this is mentioned in the passage. So this is the right option. How many big cities are there in Canada? Three big cities. What are those? Toronto, Quebec, and Vancouver. And what are the official languages of Canada? It is English and French. Okay. Next, Vancouver is good for kids because there are lots of what? There are lots of fun activities. Okay. This is how you have to answer the passage questions. Okay. Next. Now, as I've told you that it is about spoken and written expressions. Two people are talking and you have to fill the gap blank by using the appropriate conversation. Okay. Choose the correct option to complete each conversation. Ravi, dash the ball to me, Arav. Arav, here you go. So here, Ravi is talking to Arav and he is asking something, the ball to me. What can he ask? It is something related to simple present tense. And he is asking something to do to Arav. So when it is about simple tense, simple present tense, which type of verb do we use? It is first form of verb, V1 form of verb. Okay. So what is the first form of verb? It is throw. Throw is the second form of verb. Okay. So we have to use the first form of verb throw in the given conversation. Okay. Throw the ball to me, Arav. Arav, here you go. Okay. This is how we have to answer the questions. Okay. Yeah. Kevin, I'm off to school early tomorrow. Do you want to come? Ellie, seriously? Dash, I'll go at the regular time. So here the person Kevin is talking to Ellie. Okay. And he's saying that he's going to school early the next morning, tomorrow morning. And he's asking whether Ellie wants to come. So this person Ellie is replying, seriously? Dash, I'll go at the regular time. It means she's not interested to go early to the school. So she's saying that she can't say have it, seriously have it. No, it is absurd. It is making no sense at all. And seriously, me too. Me too, when do we use me too? When you want to do the same thing that the other person is doing. So this can't be our answer. And seriously, no, she's replying no chance means no, not interested. Okay. No chance, I'll go at the regular time. She wants to go at the regular time itself. So this can be our answer. And little way, seriously, little way, no. It's not giving the correct option, okay, correct answer. So the correct answer for us is no chance, okay? Next, Lucy, our new teacher is dash awesome at making math fun, okay? So Lucy is describing her new teacher. She is dash awesome at making Max fun. Something positive she is saying. She is giving an adjective to this to her new teacher. Okay, awesome is an adjective. She is praising her teacher. Okay, so it should be something good. Okay, then Amanda, really? That's good because it's usually boring. So basically, Max is boring, right? So when somebody is making it to do in a funny way, then that becomes very interesting. Okay, so now you have to use the appropriate word that completes the given conversation. So our new teacher is silly awesome. Silly is again foolish. When she's making Max fun, it can't be silly, right? And not, no, it's something negative. We can't take it. Okay, she's not awesome. No, when she's making Max fun, how can it be not? So this is not our answer. Now creepy, what do you mean by creepy? Ugly. So again, it is something negative. Okay, next, totally. Yes, it can be our answer. Totally means completely awesome. Our new teacher is completely awesome, totally awesome at making Max fun. Okay, this is how you have to write the correct answer. Next, Libby, I think it's time we went shopping. Jane, I agree. I really need new shoes. So dash. So this person Libby is asking Jane that we should go for shopping. Okay, and Jane is saying, yes, I agree. I need some new shoes, so let's go. Okay, so the correct answer here is the option one, option A, let's go. We can't say let go. This is not the correct grammatic word. Okay, we can't use that. Letting go, no, it's nothing related to continuous thing. Okay, has let go. No, again, this is not the correct one. Okay, the right answer is let's go. Pam, this is never going to happen. Sam, I agree, not even a month of dash. So the options are like Mondays, Sundays, Tuesdays, Wednesdays. So what is saying? This is never going to happen. It's not going to get completed. Okay. So basically Sunday, like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, these are nothing but the weekdays. You usually work on these days. But it is saying that even in the month of Sundays, even if you work on the Sundays, it's not going to get completed. Okay, so the correct option here is Sundays. I agree, not even the month of Sundays. Okay, next, Bill, we all need to take a look at how we reduce waste. Jill, I agree, but how can we do that? Dash. Okay, so here the person Bill is saying that we all need to take a look at how we reduce waste. So they are thinking about how to reduce waste. Okay, and Jill is saying, yes, I agree, but how can we do that effectively, efficiently? It means quickly and in an effective manner. Okay, so this is the correct answer for us. You can't use efficiency. You can't say efficient. You can't even say efficiencies. Efficient is used to describe an, it's like an adjective. Okay, but here we have to use adverb here. Okay, we are doing some action. So basically what I told you, adverb, they mostly end with ly. Most of the adverbs, they end with ly. So we are here, we only have one option that is ending with ly, and it is giving the correct adverb to us. Okay, I agree, but how can we do that efficiently? Okay, next, the last section, it's about achiever section. Yeah. So achiever section, as I've told you, you have to be very careful while answering these questions, because here you are going to get 2 marks for each question, like the previous sections. Okay. So my brother, choose the correct option to fill in the blank. My brother dash our new family house yet because he is away in college. Okay. It means he has never visited his new house, like family house, because he's away from like the house he is in college. Okay. So it is my brother does not visit. Is it making sense? No, it is describing something like active action. Okay, it's not giving the correct meaning. It's not grammatically correct. Now, my brother hasn't visited our family house yet. Yes, this is the correct option. It is describing that till now, what, like, he has not visited our family house yet. Okay, isn't visiting. Again, this is an active action, and we use is, does to describe an active action. And here we don't have as such. Okay, so the correct answer is the option B. And again, option D, will be, is something related to future, right? So we can't choose that answer, so just that option. Okay, so the correct answer is option B, has not visited. My brother has not visited our family house yet because he's away in college. Next, my sister never dash when she thinks she can win something. What do you mean by that? She never stops when she thinks she can win something. When she has that surety that she can win something, then in that case, she never stop doing what she's doing. Okay, so we have to find out for that particular word. So it is moves up. You know what is moves up? Moving up, right? So it can't be the right option. Leave that first option. Breaks in. Breaks in means to enter somewhere, into a building or in some place. Okay. So no, we can't use this option also. Come across means to meet somebody, to come across something, to meet somebody by chance. Okay. So here it's nothing like that. Okay. So my sister never lets up. Again, lets up means stop. Okay. That's what we all need. We all need for this particular blank. My sister never stops when she thinks she can win something. So it is lets up. Okay. The answer is my sister never lets up when she thinks she can win something. Okay. Now, the two teams have now been dashed to make one. It means make one, two teams to one. It means they have joined, right? So the word that gives the meaning of join is merged. Okay. So merge is the correct option for us. The two teams have now been merged to make one. Parodies, adding something to make it comfortable. Okay, so we can't use that word for this joining purpose of two teams, right? Belittle means ignoring. Okay, so it is not about ignoring. And plated means it's a car, we do something on land. Okay, so we have nothing to do with that. So the correct answer is merged to make one. Okay, now choose the word with correct spelling. You have to find out the correct spelling here. Okay, so it is confidential. What do you mean by confidential? The thing that you have to keep it secretly. Okay, that is called confidential. Okay, this is the correct word with correct spelling. Confidential. Okay, these all are the wrong options. Now, choose the most suitable option to complete the conversation. Dan, don't dash. I'm trying to concentrate. It means he's concentrating, right? And he doesn't want anybody to disturb him. Okay, don't put me off. I'm trying to concentrate. Okay, so here the correct phrasal verb that is describing that action, like don't disturb. Okay, so this is the correct phrasal verb that you have to use in. Put me off means don't disturb. Okay, and hold tight is again like don't hold me tight, something about holding. Okay, stand by me, it's like supporting me. Okay, when it is about concentrating, it's not about supporting. Okay, run away means you know what is run away, moving away. Okay, so this is about our sample paper, like how you will be getting your paper in Olympiad. Okay.